Today we're tackling a question every Figma user has ever asked at some point. Frames, groups, or sections, which one should we use and when? Understanding the differences can make your workflow smoother and your designs more structured. So let's break it down.
Have you ever worked on a Figma file and felt lost in a sea of layers? Or maybe you've tried to resize something only for it to break your layout? That's where frames, groups, sections come in. They help organize your designs, improve collaboration, and make handoff to developers seamless. But they are not interchangeable. Each has its own use case. Let's start with groups. Groups in Figma are simply a way to bundle layers together for easy movement. They don't affect constraints, auto layouts, or any advanced properties. Think of them as a basic folder for layers. They are best used for 1. Keeping small UI elements together. For example, a text and an icon. We can select both of them and simply put both of them in a group. 2. Temporary organization before refining your layout. Groups can also be used to temporarily organize your design before the proper layout. When should you not use groups? You should not use groups if you need to resize elements responsibly. Groups are not your friends as they do not support constraints very well. See how elements inside this do not scale properly. This is one of the key limitations of using groups. Now let's talk about frames, which are the powerhouse of Figma. Unlike groups, frames behave more like actual artboards and support constraints, auto layouts, and even clipping. This makes them ideal for UI designs. Frames are best used when designing full components like buttons, cards, or even modals. They also help to organize elements while keeping them scalable and structured. For example, right here in Figma, here is a frame that is enclosed in an auto layout or has auto layouts enabled in it. Resizing is easy and scalable because we are using a frame. So the elements inside here can be scaled up or scaled down because they're enclosed in an auto layout frame. If you're working on anything that needs to adapt to different screen sizes or layouts, frames are your best bet. However, you can avoid using frames when you need a quick grouping without constraints or auto layouts, where you don't need to nest with frames that leads to unnecessary complexity. Finally, let's talk about sections. These sections don't affect your design elements like frames or groups too, but they are fantastic for organizing your work. Think of sections as labeled dividers that help your workspace in it. Sections are your bodies when organizing large projects, for example, wireframes or final designs. They also keep design-related screens together. They also help to improve collaboration by visually grouping parts of your design. You avoid sections where you need functional elements like resizing or layout adjustments. For example, over here, if I resize this section, it doesn't affect the layout of the frames inside. Rather, it just resizes on its own. So you can't use frames for resizable or responsiveness. All right, so let's summarize. Use groups for basic organization and moving elements together. Use frames when designing UI components that need structure and flexibility. Use sections to organize your work for better navigation. By using this correctly, your workflow will be way efficient and your designs will be easier for teammates and developers to understand. And that's it. Hopefully this clears up when to use frames, groups, or sections in Figma. Let me know in the comments if you still have questions and if you found this video helpful. Make sure to like, make sure to subscribe, hit the notification bell for more Figma tips, and see you in the next one.